Everywhere I go, I'm listening for birds. I'm looking for birds. I'm looking for animals. I'm part of the ecosystem. I'm not separate. You think of humans as being separate. I don't think of myself as being separate from habitats and ecosystems. I kind of feel like I'm part of these ecosystems. And I've always felt that way since I was very young when I discovered my passion. And so as I've grown as a scientist, as I've grown as a global citizen, I've seen the demise of these habitats to do all these things that make it hard for not only these animals to survive, but also for humans to survive. Coming to Georgetown to try to educate the next generation around these topics, to work towards saving our world, that's a dream come true. That's doing something really tangible that could really make a difference for the future. Frankly, nature saved me. When I was 6 years old, I was a free-range kid. There was a nature center nearby, and I could just go and spend all my time in the woods in a nature center. And there was a guy there, a naturalist at this nature center, that happened to be catching birds. And he held a chickadee, much like a species like this. And I don't know what happened, but it was that image of this bird and being able to look in its eyes, and it definitely lit a passion in me for birds, for conservation, that just grew stronger and stronger as I got older. Boy, that tree is just riddled with beautiful yellow-bellied sapsucker holes, which, you know, in the winter, yellow-bellied sapsuckers spend the winters here, and they migrate further north to breed. But while they're here, they drill these beautiful holes in the trees, and then the sap starts to emerge. They drink the sap, but the sap also, because it's sweet, attracts insects. But then when you look at the design, that the yellow-bellied sapsucker, these biological engineers, then due to that tree, it's just remarkable. And that's what makes nature so remarkable. It's the biological engineers, it's the beauty of the animal itself. It's how they're foraging, how they're existing, how they're living sustainably within this remarkably complex ecosystem. So I've spent the last 20 to 30 years doing science, doing research, which is what I really love, on birds, largely migratory birds, studying them throughout the Western Hemisphere as they make their annual movements. And unfortunately, what I've discovered over that time frame is that many of these species are disappearing right before our very eyes. And what I realized that chapter of my life needed to end. I just wasn't going to be able to do the things that I needed to do to make the world a better place for birds and other wildlife. So coming to Georgetown provided that opportunity to me to build the institutional strengths to provide the degrees for that next generation to be trained to actually take on those challenges, to make the world a better place for wildlife, for birds that I love, as well as for humans. What we're building here at Georgetown the Earth Commons is, it's a movement. We want to get the green in the blue and the gray. That's sort of our motto here. And that means putting up signs of the environment, signs of sustainability, why it matters, different perspectives from around the world here. So if you're in the library, Lowinger Library, and you're studying, all of a sudden you look up and you see this incredible image of Melissa Singer and some of her abstract artwork where she's taken these incredible images, like in this case, a photograph of drought, and put it into some artistic rendition that sort of makes you think about what this really is. What does this represent? But it gets people thinking about the science, about the environmental harm, in a variety of different ways, in this case, climate change. So it's essential that we at Georgetown start to understand in their very fabric why the environment matters, why it's something that we are inextricably linked to. These are the questions of our time. These are the problems we've got to grapple with. Because if we don't deal with these issues, we don't figure out how to minimize our impact on the environment, nothing else matters. Yeah, this is the time of year where you start to get these migratory birds coming back up north and heading to their breeding territories again. I choose to be optimistic that we can learn here, that we can create institutional strengths like we're building at Georgetown with the Earth Commons, and train the next generation in ways that will
you know, spread the environmental gospel.
Ah, just a beautiful bird right there.
And I think what we're creating within the Earth Commons, within the Earth Commons Institute, is really going to be a magical opportunity for students from all over the world to come to Washington, D.C. to learn how they can have hope for the future around environment sustainability. In so many other ways, we're providing the hope for our common home that we have to provide so people can be optimistic about our future.